Hey babe,
what are you doing?
Well, the carpet looks like crap because the cat's been ripping at it. So I think I'm just gonna rip all the carpet out.
Okay. Do you have a plan for what you want to do?
No. I mean, I'll just ask Jamie. He'll tell me what to do. Just trying to get a look at what's underneath this stuff. Have some kind of idea of what I can do. So, I don't know.
8 o'clock on Monday night. Looks like the carpet's about to go. Right, Ellie? We're gonna get rid of the carpet? Babe, where'd you go?
What?
Where'd you go?
I had to get some gloves so I don't cut myself. Had to get a hat too so I look better on camera. So we got everything cleared off and I got some of this leftover flooring, this laminate flooring that we used in our bedroom and in the family room. Some leftover box of this, so I'm thinking maybe trying to utilize this, maybe doing that, you know, on the stairs themselves and on the landings, and then on the rising part, I guess you'd call it the riser, I don't know, but on this back part here, we can paint that white or gray or something like that, and then do the flooring on the top. And that will save some money. I think it would look pretty good. And then just trim out the sides. I don't know, we'll see. We'll talk to the boys and see what they think about it, and we'll go from there. So I just realized that I do not have enough flooring to do this little area right here. I'm probably short like two pieces. I only have one box of this flooring left, and I realized by searching the internet that they don't sell it anymore. So that's a big problem. Unbelievable. I mean, this keeping up with the Joneses stuff is getting out of control. I mean, I feel like I gotta keep up with Ray. You know, he's doing all these cool things at his house. If I don't do them at my house, it's like I'm kind of a loser or something. So I don't know what I'm gonna do now. I gotta talk to the wife and see what another option is, but I don't know what to do. So what we're gonna do now is we're going to change up plans here. We're going to do new pine treads, paint the risers, and I'm gonna rip down some pine for the landing there, and we're gonna make that kind of look like wood flooring. I'm gonna take my daughter Ryan and we're gonna go to Lowe's and hope and pray that we can find like one box or a couple pieces of this flooring laying around, because I just did some research and they've only discontinued like 2 months ago. And I've seen it at the Lowe's before, so we're just gonna go and on a pipe dream, hope we get a couple pieces. What do you think, Rye?
I think we'll find something.
Yeah?
I have hopes. All
right. Let's give it a try. Come on. All right, so I just talked to my man WC here, and he said that he thinks they may have a pallet that's uncounted for up in the stock room or something like that. So he's going to take a look at it. So we're going to cross our fingers. So now we're going to go look for some stair treads. We got our stair treads.
Wow!
It wasn't a total waste. I think it was a good day, yeah? Okay, so what are you saying now, lunch?
Yes.
Do it. Molding around the staircase, which I have to get off. And then I'm gonna pop these front pieces off, the treads. And then I gotta get these old treads off so I can put the new ones on. But the problem I'm seeing already is that all of this stuff on the sides where it's not painted is all going to be a problem. So I'm either gonna have to spackle and paint it or somehow try to put maybe something in there. I don't know what. A skirt board, that's the word I was looking for. Maybe take these treads off and then cut the risers back a little bit so that I can slide a skirt board in there to cover all that nastiness and make it look nice. I want to take one of those treads off and see what's going on under there, because I'm really curious to see what kind of staircase whatever he built. I don't even know what it is. I feel like I'm working at Jones's house, but let's take it apart and see what we got going on. They have the drywall going over the top of the tread, so to get a skirt board in there I think is going to be impossible. So I don't know what I'm gonna do. I guess there I'd have to add drywall or do something. I don't know. It's turned into a complete disaster. Thank God it's only the bottom stairs here. I think the top ones will be a lot better, but these bottom ones are a nightmare. See, here's where the problem I was saying is that the old tread off, and you put the new tread on, obviously that would be slid back, but now you see where they didn't paint, so now I'm going to sand all that down and paint it. And you all know how much I love to sand and paint. Maybe I can get Jones over here to do it. I mean, he's not busy doing anything, right? He could do it. Start taking these treads off, and I think the best way is I'm just going to sawzall them. So I bought a new blade. I'm going to sawzall them off, and what I need to do is I need to be able to still walk up and down the stairs, but I still need to take care of all this stuff on the side that's a total mess. So what I think I'll do is I think I'll cut them down to where they just touch there and just touch on this there, and then I'll screw it down just in the middle. That way it'll give me an inch or so on each side to kind of figure out what I want to do on the sides before I put the real treads on. Again, it's one way to do it, I guess. All right, so another thing I need to do is I need to pull out all these little staples. When they put the carpeting in, put all these little staples in, and I gotta pull all of them out. Probably be a good job for my kids. Ryan, Rowan, come here, please. Yeah, I need you to take these pliers, and I need you to pull all these little staples out. You can do that for me? Thanks, champ. How's it going, babe?
Not fun at all.
All right, I took this many staples out of just these two risers. And I have to take them out of all of those risers. This is crazy, man. I need to ask somebody what I should do. Well, if I call Jones, you know what he's gonna tell me to do, take them all out. I'm gonna call Jamie. He's gonna tell me to take them all out. Maybe I'll call Eric. Maybe Eric will just say pound them in. That's probably the best bet. That's what I'll do. I got another little problem here that's probably out of my realm, is that this is the top tread and it goes into the floor there. So if I rip this out, that's gonna be like a 2-inch step down from up there. Which I guess isn't the worst idea, but I don't know what I need to do. Maybe I can talk to Jamie. Maybe I put that tread right on top of this one and just make this first step down a little bit higher. Maybe like an inch or so higher than the others. I don't know. So I was going to try and time lapse this, but by myself, it probably would have been like a 40-minute time lapse. So I'm not going to do it. So what I'm doing here is I'm pulling off the old treads, like I mentioned before, and then I'm shorten them down so that I can leave space here between the walls so I can spackle and sand and paint up where the old treads are at, but still use these functionally right now. And then once I get all the sides painted and sanded and looking good, then I can go ahead and measure and put the new treads in. So this is what happens when you don't have to work all day long. You get stuck at home doing this. It sucks. Seems like day 17, and I'm down in my stairwell again in my basement. And I guess today I'm gonna work on getting the walls prepped and getting all these staples out of the risers so that I can paint. And hopefully next week I can get Jones over here to help me put these treads in. So here we go. So, you know what really sucks is that ever since I started working for Perkins and working with Ray, that I'm actually doing things the right way. So usually I would have just ripped this carpet out, sanded it down a little bit and painted it. But no, now here I am pulling out all these staples, filling holes with wood putty. This is getting ridiculous. Risers are nailed off or anything in the middle. It's just on the ends. And a few of them are actually missing on the bottom. So it means only the top one's holding on, but I guess that's one way to do it. Okay, so as I'm pulling all this apart, a couple of the risers had some cracks in them. And I don't know, man, you know me, I was just gonna leave them. But, you know, it's almost like that, those cartoons where you got like the good kid sitting on this shoulder and the bad kid sitting on this shoulder. Well, I'm this one over here thinking, it's a little crack, it's no big deal, I'm just gonna let it fly. And then I got Jones over here tweeting in my ear going, you know, you should do it the right way, you should do it the right way, so. It's killing me, but I guess I'm going to do it the right way and replace a couple of them. So I got my handy palm sander from DeWalt. Got me some 80 grit. I'm going to go ahead and hit these walls and hit these risers and see if I can't make it look somewhat respectable. We'll see. So I just talked to Jamie. I called him. It's so nice having somebody like Jamie that was so knowledgeable. So as you can see, my last tread here, I can't really take it off because it goes under the old floor from upstairs. So I need to make this tread on top of here. The problem I'm gonna run into is that now I'm adding an inch onto already inch and a half material. And down here, I'm not going to have that. I'm adding an inch, but I'm taking away an inch and a half. So there's gonna be definitely some math issues there. So Jamie, against my better judgment again, said that I should take some rip strips and rip them and put them all on the old stairs underneath the treads, put a little half inch piece to get my height all the same as the top. So it's gonna be a lot of extra work, but I definitely think it is the right thing to do. Again, having Jamie there is great, but again, he always makes you do stuff the right way. So, all right, so I found some old paint in the garage that matches this color. So I'm gonna go ahead and touch up paint the sides there, and then I'll go ahead and paint the risers when I'm done. Man, I wish Jones was here. You guys know I suck at painting. If you guys have ever seen our channel, or you've definitely seen the Perkins channel, when we're doing stairs, there's always one thing that you don't see, and that's me. And the reason is because I'm not the stair guy. I really don't have any idea what I'm doing. So I'm trying to figure out, I gotta put this skirt board in, and then I gotta shim up these risers so that the treads all match up, and my brain's kinda going nuts right now. So I'm sure I'm not gonna probably do it the right way, but hopefully it'll get done to where it looks halfway decent. So I got some of this 3/4 inch material left over that I had laying around. It's some old tongue and groove that I took from one of the jobs. Thanks, Perkins. So I'm gonna use this material for my spacing. I got all the tongues ripped off. So I'm gonna just cut this down to the width of the stairs, put this down, flush it up to the front, and then I will put the treads right on top of these, and that way it'll space out so that my spacing off the first step is the same as all the others. So as you can see, the material I had was only so wide, so I got a little gap here in the back. Of course, in talking to Jamie, he said it should be filled in, so I guess I'm gonna fill it in. So I got some material left over that I'm gonna rip down to these strips. I'll put those in, glue them real good, shoot them real good, and then that'll be a nice solid surface for when I put my actual real tread on. And we'll glue that down real good and shoot that down, and that way it'll be nice and solid. It's coming along. Don't know if it's right or not, but it's coming along. So we're to the point where we need to paint the risers. You guys know how much I love to paint, but maybe I can get Stephanie to help me. Steph!
What?
Hey, come here for a second. Hey, you know how you're always saying how much you want to help me like around the house?
No, I don't remember saying that.
You don't remember?
No.
Well, we need to paint the risers. You know, the paint you and the kids picked out? You want to help me paint?
No, I don't. I'm actually busy. I'm picking out campsites for the summer.
You're joking me. This sucks. So the landing downstairs, I want it to be the same material as the stairs, so I bought some extra treads. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna rip the nose off, and then I'm gonna rip these in half. They'll be about 5 inches wide. And then we'll use that just like hardwood floor and put it down on the landing, glued and shoot it down, and then we'll sand it and poly that so that it matches the stairs. I think it'll look good. So I'm gonna go ahead and use Jamie's table saw here. I'm gonna rip these down and get them prepped up so that when Jones comes over, we can get it laid down. So Jones was supposed to help me do my stairs today, and I can't get a hold of him. I don't know where he's at. And I'm over here at Ace, and I noticed some lights were on at Jamie's. So I'm just gonna come over here and see if maybe he tried to get away from me today and come work at Jamie's. I see his car back there. Well, 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 would you look at that? Look who it is. Man, you really don't want to help me with my stairs, huh?
What?
You really don't want to help me with my stairs, do you?
Dude, I would much rather help you with your stairs.
Look at him over here by himself painting, trying to get out to helping me with stairs, dude. That is so wrong. You suck.
You think I really would rather paint than help you do stairs?
Looks like it. Back in my basement again. It's day like, I don't know, 106. But we're gonna try to get some stuff done today. I got some material, I got some tools. I went to Jamie's house, got a pass load, 16 gauge I'm gonna shoot the treads down with. I got some liquid nails. I got Jono's Stairmaster. The Stair Wizard. I have no idea how it works. We're gonna try to figure that thing out, see how that goes. And then to top it all off, it's pouring rain outside. So I actually have my station outside here in the rain. I got it easy up there so I don't get soaking wet. And I got my table saw, my chop saw. So I'm gonna try to get some work done today. And of course, Jones is not here again. Got my makeshift skirt boards there. Again, it was just because the walls were so messed up, and actually this one over here, the treads actually went underneath the drywall and there was about 2 inches of drywall missing. So I figured it'd just be easy just to put these little skirt boards in there. I don't know if they're right. They probably should go up higher over there to match a baseboard, but they're in and is what it is. So let's go ahead and try and get a stair in. Alrighty, well, it only took me about an hour or so, but I finally got the first two in. I think they look pretty good, man. Stair Wizard's doing good. I got my nice cuts. I'm happy with it. I just want to make a point that I am putting this liquid nail subfloor adhesive on the back of all these planks that I'm putting down just to make sure that they don't squeak and open around. So I think I had a pretty good day, man. I got all the treads on. Got the landing done. I got some baseboard in. Looking pretty good, I think. Gotta do some more trim, little trims around the edges there, underneath, because I had to add that piece of material. So I'm gonna put some little moldings in there, and the top piece in, lined up with the floor there. So I think it's good, man. So I don't know, all you on that channel are saying, oh, Ray Bay Builder Buddies, Ray Bay Builder Buddies. Well, I'm thinking I don't even need Ray. I'm just gonna do JJ Builder Bro. I'll start my own channel. I'm just joking, I really do need you, Ray. This sucks working by yourself. Becca! Becca!
My name's Stephanie.
Oh, gosh. Oh, shoot, sorry, I can't say that. Oh, I'm sorry, Stephanie, yeah, Stephanie. Hey, so you think you can sand the floor while I'm gone?
Yeah.
Yeah, if you can just sand all this down, mm-hmm. and then vacuum it, and then put some poly on it, and I'll be back later.
Got it.
Love you.
Love you.
Okay, so day 147 in my basement. I think today we're gonna do some trim. I was supposed to do it yesterday, but it was so nice outside, the wife told me I had to work outside in the yard. So that's what I did yesterday. So today is rainy, we're not working with Perkins. Ray's doing his own thing, so I'm gonna knock out this trim. Hopefully get the trim on, get the second coat of poly on, paint these baseboards and be done. All right, so I finished the trim on the stairs, started working now on this landing. We want the flooring to match. I had one box left over from when I did the floors last time. So with that being said, I guess I'm gonna have to pull Jones since we have it in our bedroom here. I'm just gonna find the most inconspicuous place and I'm gonna steal it. So I'm gonna go in my wife's closet and steal it from this back row. And that way for now you won't see it, and then somewhere down the road I'll just have to rip all this flooring out and put something new in, some carpet or something. So okay, so I just got off of work this past weekend. I took the railings off for downstairs and I put a fresh coat of black paint on them. My wife wanted them black, but I have to put a second coat on them, so I'm gonna put a second coat on those. Put a second coat on these brackets and things like that. I think all I got left is to paint the trim and put one more coat of poly on the stairs and I will be done. All right, I'm going downstairs.
To do what?
Well, I gotta put that second coat of poly on the stairs and I gotta paint the trim.
I already did it.
Wait, what?
I already did it.
What do you mean you already did it? When?
Today, on my day off.
You did?
Are you crying?
All right, well, I believe I'm all finished. I got the landing downstairs matched up with the flooring that I took from Stephanie's closet. We got baseboards in, we got stairs done, painted, two coats of poly, baseboards in with fresh paint. I think everything looks great. We got the handrail in. She wanted to do black just to add a little bit of some color, some darkness to it. I am gonna have to replace that at some point to match that, but that's all right. And then going upstairs, we have the stairs all done. They walk nice, they feel great, leading up right into the living room, man. So I'm so stoked. Thank you so much for sticking with me on this one. It got done, and my wife's gonna love it. So I appreciate it, and thank you so much. And like Eric says, thanks for building with me. Have a great one.